I can see it in the way she looks at me. All I'd have to do is reach out and take her hand, and she'd be mine. Why am I talking to myself?
And the tides have turned. Welcome back, awesome people, to Cocktails and Consoles. It's Melissa, and we've now reunited with Farrah. We got some work to do. Something to do with this stonework. Where did we have to move her? Not easy for a woman to kind of regain her stance at the table, for lack of a better term, once she's said, I love you.
What if I get into trouble?
Wow. But she pulls it off nicely. Not saying it's a sign of weakness to admit that you're in love with someone, but it does lead for an unbalanced state. When one person has said that they love the other person, and the other person has yet to respond, let alone acknowledge. But Farrah pulls it off kind of nicely. I don't even know how far I'm supposed to turn this. There we go.
There you are. Are you sure I'm not slowing you down?
All right.
Still, I love his sass. Oh god, we've got to clean some house first. Welcome to the light puzzle. This one's going to take a little bit of time, but it is a fun puzzle.
We'll need to go back through the royal palace.
All right then, let's find the way out.
Oof. All right. So this episode might go a little bit long, just because I want to get you through the entirety of this light puzzle. Alright. So the key to this whole thing is wherever you see dirt on the ground, that's where one of these things needs to go. Thankfully, these things can't go upstairs or downstairs alone or in pairs, so you're gonna find them about where they need to be. No, guess nothing I need to do there. I really didn't need that book from Edgar Allan Poe. Okay. You're right there, you're there. Good, 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 good. You, I need to move. I'm fairly certain, yes. You need to move.
There's a crack. I'll go.
It's a nice when you can line it up properly the first time.
I know she did. I didn't dream it. At least, I think I didn't. It's quite natural, really. Her kingdom's conquered. She has nothing, no one to protect her. She needs me. I can see it in the way she looks at me. All I'd have to do is reach out and take her hand, and she'd be mine. Why am I talking to myself?
Best part in the game. Oh. So, it's nice to watch the slow evolution of the prince. He's responding to her emotionally, that much I can tell, although his aims are not exactly altruistic. Though it does make me wonder, and to the awesome men out there who watch my channel, I'm kind of curious. The damsel in distress. When it comes to how much allure that is on a woman, I'm curious to hear, is that something that you guys actually respond to? Or is that just an antiquated thing? I don't know. Oh, right, I actually have to turn on the damn thing. Whoopsie. Yeah, hi. Big blinding light, I need you. I love that it's a spade, my most favorite of the card shapes. No, what are you doing? Whoa. Slow your roll. There we go. I totally missed that. There we go.
You did it!
Thank you. Oh my god. Getting vertigo just watching this cutscene.
Look! It's the same symbol that was on the pillar!
Stay there! I'll come to you!
It's no use moving the mirror. There's no light beam.
I can see that.
Done and done, yes. You're just big old ball of light. Okay. Back to the spas. What's weird is that even throughout this entire game, you never figure out where this is. In any of the games, they make no mention. Now, each game has its own little, hey, come through here and get some more life. And they don't explain where it comes from, where it goes. All right. So if we can't go that way, we're gonna have to find another way to get there, which I do believe is through. Hello, let's not die. God damn it. Prince. Now I'm not referencing the late, great musical artist. This guy literally has no name. It's a running gag in all of the Prince of Persia games, is that he's never been given a name, which is an interesting concept, and I love how they play off of it in all of the games, especially at the end of this one. Cool. We done here, bats? Fantastic.
Listen to this. Of what use is reason against the power of love? Love is life. So if you want to live, die in love. Die in love if you want to stay alive.
What's that supposed to mean?
I thought you'd like it.
If you want to be useful, try finding a book that'll tell us how to get out of here.
This isn't that kind of game.
I'm kind of agreeing here.
She thinks this is a game.
Did I hit it? I hit it, I think.
Stay there.
I hit it.
I'll come to you.
Perfect. Okay. La 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 la, and down. Oof, God. This scares the hell out of me. I don't even know what. Oh wow, I got it all the way there. Nice. Shit, I can't get from there. I'm gonna have to do this. Slide, thank you. Even though it took off some friggin' health, but that's fine. Alley-oop. Now.
Now what? There was one more symbol. Do you remember? It was in the main hall.
Uh-huh. Well, if that's all I can do here, there's a rope there. I don't know how the sword is still in one piece. Okay, so we need to hit that. So I'm gonna need you to come out this way. Where am I going? There we go. And I need to turn that light. That works. You're here? All right. New sword! Damn. That is a sexy beast. Why ruin your swords? All right. I think here's a good place to end for this episode. Hope you guys are doing well. Love to hear you guys' feedback on the game. How are you liking it? Are you looking forward to maybe doing Warrior Within, which is the second, or the Two Thrones, which is the third? Definitely let me know. Any likes, comments, subscribes, as always, much appreciated, as they definitely help out the channel, and I will see you, awesome people, in the next episode. Cheers!